We're having later this week a roundtable on Russian cyber aggression downstairs in our Peace Tech Accelerator. This, of course, is something that has dominated a lot of the news over the last several years. And you just mentioned that the committee has been active. Can you say a bit more about the ways in which you see, I mean, cyber has become one of these all-encompassing, slightly mysterious realms of concern.
Well, it runs a broad gamut from digital ads to some very Stuxnet kind of penetration software. So some of the best stuff you really can't talk about too much, but clearly exposing digital ads and seeing what they've been able to do in Italy and in Germany would be helpful, as well as here.
I think in some of the cyber activity, we're seeing our legal system go ahead. I mean, we're prosecuting individuals with Yahoo issue. We're actually moving ahead legally. That's important to do to the extent that we can. And then we have to, again, getting back to the theme of a strengthened West, dealing with the cyber issue and the way that they're used to for corrupt business practices, but also for, affecting our democracies. We're stronger working together. And so, again, we have to promote a much better coalition dealing with it. Because, and particularly from our side, that'll include the private side as well. Congress has it's been well celebrated on TV when we've had some of the witnesses in from the social media companies in front of Congress trying to hold their feet to the fire. But we have to continue to work. They're part of the solution as well. It's something government itself cannot control. We can influence and we can do things that are in our realm, but we do need the help of private companies,